Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sergeant Ong, and I am the platoon sergeant of Ninja Company Platoon 2, Section 2. As all of you know, recently, I just had an Ask Sergeant Ong segment on YouTube, asking all of you out there to leave me whatever questions you might have about NS, the SAF, or whatever about the military. And I'm very happy with the questions I received, because a lot of it is very good. But some of you ask questions that waste my time. So today, I'm only going to answer questions that are not a waste of my time. So, let's go. Right now, I'm at the SOC ground, and somebody asked this question: is there only one way to solve the SOC? And my answer to that is yes and no. Yes, because during training, soldiers go through the SOC in a controlled environment with rules. And this is to better prepare and condition our soldiers to know when and how to react and move in a real-life situation. And no, because yeah, there are many other ways to complete the SOC, but if you do it during my training, you will be in serious trouble. Understand? Now that you know what the SOC is all about, let me give you a live demonstration. But of course, not I do. I got somebody to do for me. Let's go. Master, master, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, master, don't waste my time. Very good. Whoa, not bad, not bad.
Oh, keep your head low.
Somebody asked me to give them a review of the SAR 21, which is the Singapore Assault Rifle 21. It is specially designed by Singapore Technologies and weighs in, without magazine, 3.82 kg. With magazine, 4.3 kg. And this rifle right here is specially designed to counter the weaknesses of the M16. Now, for those of you wondering, the maximum effective range of the SAR 21 is 460 meters. And the rate of fire that this baby can pack is 450 rounds to 650 rounds per minute. So, you better run. Somebody asked, why is it so important to serve National Service? The police will do it, what? My answer to that is, when guys serve National Service, they will not only serve in the police, but also the Civil Defense Force and the SAF, which consists of the Army, the Navy, and the Air Force. So what's the difference between the police and the SAF? The police is in charge of maintaining law and order in Singapore and also ensuring the internal security. Whereas the SAF's main job is to protect Singapore from external threats. Without NS, the SAF would be very small, damn small. But it is because we have National Service. That's why the SAF consists of a strong force of 350,000 men. Somebody also asked me, Singapore is so safe, need NS for what? We won't have war on what? Hey, let me tell you, Singapore is so safe, then you lock your door for what? Oh, come in and break in what, right? It's the same logic. Remember Captain Tan, OC of Ninja Company in Our Boys to Men? He said, it is because of what we are wearing, that's why we are able to celebrate National Day every year. So, brothers, conserving. Yeah. That is all the questions that we have for today, and unfortunately, we have come to the end of today's video. I hope you have learned something valuable today, and this is your very handsome, very friendly, very well-dressed Platoon Sergeant Ong. Signing off. Have a good day.